Now look at the step to disassemble the battery, as the pack is sealed to make it disassemble hard. The cover is pasted so that it may be hard to remove it. With the help of screwdriver, put it in the split among the two cover of battery pack that is beside the cover and attempt to turn the screwdriver and unglue a small side. Now you have a clear understanding of interior of Li cell. You see the pack comprises of 6 Li cells and the circuit board which has all the safety circuits. After detailed test, you will see the batteries are connected in 3 series of 2 batteries each one. Look at the image to comprehend the actual structure as you see the characteristics of each cell as per to the connection. How these Li cells are identified? Part number CGP345010 indicated the Li cell when mentioned over it. If you can see in date sheet how these Li cells are identified, part number CGP345010 indicated the Li cell when mentioned over it. If you can see in data sheet, this cell has nominal voltage 37 volt and 1400 mAh. For reference, kindly see the image. The value of cell is calculated according to the battery pack characteristics, but the part number of each cell are identical. Next is how to find these cell. You have recognized the cell that comprises the pack. It's time to verify if you can find it in the market. Now with the help of screwdriver, lift first battery and cut the first connector as seen on the right photo. Lift cautiously second cell and trying not to damage circuit board. Then cut rest of the metallic contact and keep it as it is for using it in near future. Now cut the other side of contact that goes to PCB board. Now continue without cutting other edge of contact and remove the next cell in series. When removing last cell, you must pay more attention because there is a PTC attached on top of it. Now take off the glue tape and free it from the cell. After that, you can also take off this cell. Place all the cell in a distance as shown in the picture. At last, remove carefully the safety circuit board without damaging it. As you can see, there is a small circuit board joined on top of the battery beneath the orange tape. Now begin heating your soldering iron and take away orange tape to free the board. After this, desolder contacts of lead which are fixed to battery cell. Now the battery should look like this. Take away white cables but do not remove white coating that guard battery terminals from short circuits. Take out the double-sided adhesive tape as it is too thick and requires to be removed so the battery fits back to its plates. Now take the old battery and take out the top white coating. Add the blue heat shrinkable plastic as we are about to use it to the new batteries. After that, place blue plastic on new battery so that cut side faces thin glue tape that we have not removed. Then press plastic glue on top of tape. Next, connect the white protecting coating you have removed from the old batteries. Do again all the steps for all the batteries. Now you must have 6 ready to solder batteries. Solder all batteries in the series of 2 as given in the diagram. Do again this step to make the 3 sets of 2 batteries in parallel. After that, solder set on circuit board paying attention to the polarity. Put the PCB with batteries solder in the unique plastic box. You should have tried if it fit the box in the step by soldering. Using multimeter, check the short circuit and by measuring the cell, you will find that are not fully discharged. It is suggested to pile up Li cell in a 40-50% charge level. If everything looks fine, apply some adhesive around plastic case. You can also use fix to adhesive the plastic enclosure tight. As long as the adhesive takes As long as the adhesive takes to dry, place the old cell on a separate small plastic bag and dispose to a battery recycling bucket. Do not throw it along with the ordinary rubbish. If everything is okay, the indicator should show that battery is charging normally. The arrow in the above image showed this. The first charge took around 2.330 hours to complete and the first discharge lasts about 2.45 hours. That is a good result. Now your notebooks look like new. Thank you.